Hi everybody, this is Gad Saad. I hope that you're having a good Sunday. Some of you may have found out that Facebook has decided to lift its ban on posts that purport that COVID may have been a man-made virus and that the virus might have leaked from the noble Wuhan virology lab. Now, of course, the people who were unwilling to concede that that was a possibility, let alone a certainty, are exactly those who are currently looking for the real killers in the O.J. Simpson case. But more importantly, I'd like you to stop for a second and think about truly how Orwellian it is that these social media companies that control, you know, how our world is viewed and shaped and the flow of any discussion in ways that no dictator has ever been able to control in the history of humanity, they decide if a theory is worthy of exploration. And if they think that it isn't, then they ban your voice. How is that different from the case of Galileo, where the church said, listen, pretty boy, you're saying that the earth is not the center of the universe? House arrest. Oh, Socrates, you're polluting the minds of our Athenian young folks. Death to you. And on and on. The reflex to shut down the voices of those with whom the overlords disagree with is one that defines human history. All that's happening on Facebook and Twitter and YouTube and so on is that now instead of beheading you or stoning you or lynching you or crucifying you or putting you under house arrest, we simply press a button and you cease to exist on social media. The reflex is the same, the methods are different. So I implore all those of you who repeatedly say, but bruh, private company, it's not the government, to maybe actually look for where you've lost your brains or who stole your brains. The reflex of freedom of speech and freedom of inquiry doesn't solely, the responsibility of these freedoms doesn't solely rest on the government protecting those rights or infringing on those rights. It's part of a general zeitgeist. Does the culture promote freedom of speech, freedom of conscience, freedom of inquiry, freedom of religion, or it doesn't? Sure, the government is part of that process of either eradicating those freedoms or defending those freedoms, but it's part of a larger story. So when social media companies have the power to say, oh, okay, my bad, now we will tolerate those who are stating that, you know, the COVID virus may have been man-made. In related news, water is wet. In related news, you're more likely to get a sunburn during the day than in the middle of the night. That's not a good place for society to be. I wish I could say slowly we inch. Take care, everybody.